What are you, blind? Why, you don't see there's a line? I've been standing here a half hour already. You get to just walk in? Must be nice being the sheriff. Do whatever the fuck you like.
I don't have time for this.
Yeah, you and all the rest of them in there. Fucker.
Because you are the one bringing this to me, Miss Snow. The one who so simply stumbled upon this catastrophe on our very doorstep. The last thing I need with Mayor Cole away is a hysteria. Do you understand me?
Yes, of course I
do. Don't interrupt me, Miss Snow.
You asked me a question.
Don't change the subject. You are to blame for this unpleasantness, Miss Snow.
I brought you this news as soon as I could.
You are trusted to keep things running smoothly around here. This is a disaster.
It isn't anyone's fault. Instead of trying to assign blame, maybe we should figure out how to catch the fucker who did this.
Oh, is that how you see things? Sheriff, you are the one charged with protecting the citizens of Fabletown. Your failure to do so cost someone their life and the safety of the entire community. Tell me you've been doing something. Are there any leads? Suspects? Anything. Anything at all. Any shred of evidence you two know what the hell you're doing.
Yeah, her pimp.
Her... Was she,
Yeah. She was worried about a money situation.
Well, this is just wonderful. Not only is a fable killed, but it was a fable hooker to boot. You two need to get a handle on this situation quickly and quietly.
The last thing we need is all of Fabletown knowing there's a killer amongst us. Snow.
Yes? Sir?
Call Vivian right this minute and let her know I'm coming in early for my massage.
I will.
Where is the bottle of wine you were to purchase? Don't bother. Forget it.
Can't do anything right.
Do your job, Sheriff. Or we'll find someone who can.
You would have just pissed him off more.
All right.
Well, that could have gone better. Well, I guess I should have listened to you and waited.
Wasn't gonna say I told you so.
You don't have to say it. It would have been better to have more to offer. Get our ducks in a row. Oh, Crane doesn't like people smoking and... Never mind. Smoke away.
Who gets a massage this early?
Crane. It doesn't really matter the time of day. A mere scent of stress and he's out the door.
Is he gone?
Yes, thankfully. Buffkin!
Hello, Miss Snow.
Drinking? This early? Where did you get that?
It was by Mr. Ichabod's desk.
Then don't you think it probably belongs to him?
Maybe. How are you today, Mr. Bigby?
Fuck off, Buffkin.
Buffkin, get the books.
Which books?
The ones with all the fables in it.
Not sure that was any more specific.
Bring the first three.
Be back in a few minutes.
He knows the ones I'm talking about. There's bound to be information on her here. Somewhere. We'll at least be able to get her real name from the books whenever Buffkin finds them. In the meantime, poke around. Maybe the mirror can help. I really have to get this appointment squared away, but let me know if you need anything. Hello, Vivian? Hi, this is Snow White, Mr.
Hey, magic mirror. I got a question.
You know the rule.
I don't have time for this shit.
Your impatience is callow. You're needlessly cruel, but have some respect for our history and rules.
Mirror, mirror. If you're able, tell me all about this fable.
See? Was that so hard?
Yeah, I'm about 2 seconds away from kicking a hole in you.
There's no need for that. Fine. Of which fable do you wish to know?
I don't know her name. Not yet, anyway.
Well, until you do, I can't help you.
Show me the woodsman. Where is he?
What you see is complete. The woodsman stumbles down a street.
No shit. Which street?
I'm sorry, Bigby. I can only show you what can be seen.
Show me the woodsman. Show me Snow White.
Not much of a request. She's in this very room.
Show me Buffkin.
Hey, put down the bottle and get to work.
Still looking.
Show me the woodsman. Nobody right now.
Very well. Please return should you wish to ask about someone else. Or someone new.
Well, I'm sure we'll get it all cleared up. Okay. Thank you.
Try. Magic lamps are pretty much just lamps after the genie's been freed. Strength. I guess it comes in all forms. Tarot cards. Jack brought them back from Appalachia. Who knows?
where they were before then, or what he did to get them.
We'll start with these. Any information on fables in our community will be somewhere in these books.
Yeah, dwarves. Less said about that, the better.
Yeah, that's me. Back when... long time ago.
Haven't seen him in a while.
Well, that's how you looked when we met, remember?
Yeah, I remember. And him.
The woodsman?
Yep, and his axe. Yeah, the two of them. I wonder what the story was. Beauty and happier days. And her man, Beast.
Funny.
Colin and his brothers. I've seen this before. This symbol on the man's clothes, it's the same as the rings.
Could be her father, or husband. This has most of the emblems of the old days, and usually what family they come from. If it's in here, we'll have her name.
Great.
What?
I can't read any of this shit.
I can help. Maybe it will brighten your shitty mood a little.
Unlikely. Bufkin, translate.
An exquisite design from the good china of Toad Hall.
Mr. Toad?
He probably wrote this in himself.
Bufkin, translate.
An exquisite design from the good china of Toad Hall.
Mr. Toad?
He probably wrote this in himself.
I haven't seen Badger around for a while.
He likes his privacy, I think.
I wish Toad would like his a bit more. Ichabod Crane. Scared shitless.
What's that?
Your boss. His finest moment. Hard to understand how he ended up running this place.
Well, maybe it's time that changed.
Had. Bufkin, translate.
An exquisite design from the good china of Toad Hall.
Mr. Toad?
He probably wrote this in himself.
Thank you.
Mirror, mirror, blah, blah, able, blah, blah, blah about this fable.
Of which fable do you wish to know?
Show me Donkey Skin Girl.
The name you are using no longer applies. She cast off her nickname to help her disguise. Get me her real name and I'll show you what I can.
I'm this close.
I'm sorry, but threats won't help you. Find her name, Bigby.
Show me the woodsman. Nobody right now.
Very well. Please return should you wish to ask about someone else. Or someone new.
This is the one. Where is this symbol from? Which family or story?
That's an odd one. Family name? Alelairau? I'll go look it up.
Alelairau. That means every kind of fur in German.
Donkey skin.
Yes. What does it say?
Donkey skin girl, also known as donkey skin. Also known as... ass skin. prefers to go by the name Faith. Poetic?
Bufkin, we don't need the commentary.
The story of Donkey Skin. There was once a great king with a beautiful queen. The queen grew ill and had her husband promise to only marry the most beautiful girl in the kingdom. After a long search, it became clear that the only woman in the land that could match her beauty was... his daughter, Faith. She had a magic cloak made from the skin of her father's prized donkey that would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom. Eventually, she married a prince who could see past the magic cloak and knew her true beauty. And they lived happily ever after. Should I mark it, Miss Snow?
Yes. Please. And what's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
We got what we came for.
Yeah.
Her name's Faith. She was married to Prince Lawrence. I mean, that's more than
Her name was Faith.
Yeah.
We should talk to the husband.
You think he did it?
With this sort of thing? It's usually the person who knew them best.
Or it's someone completely random.
Mirror, mirror, blah, blah, able, blah, blah, blah about this fable.
Of which fable do you wish to know?
Show me
Do me faith.
Through powerful magic, her whereabouts concealed. Unfortunately for you, these lips are sealed.
What?
These lips are sealed. It's not my choice of phrasing, Bigby. It's simply the way this has to be.
Show me Faith's father, the old king. Guess that crosses him off the suspect list. He's a prince, I think. Show me Prince Lawrence. What's he been doing? Where is this?
Where's what?
Do you know where Prince Lawrence lives?
If he's a prince, probably relocated in the South Bronx. Yellow building, red window shutters.
Red frames.
Yep, that's the one. I can take us there.
Nobody right now.
Anything we can use?
Yeah, that'll have to do for now.
Come on, we're going over there. Sorry, I have to get that. Hello, Woodland's business office. Yes, I... He is. Hold on. Bigby, it's for you.
Bigby, it's me, Toad. You there?
What do you want?
Bigby, shit. Listen, right? There's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things. Get over here, Bigby, before he... Oh, wait, hang on.
What was that about?
Hard to say. Something going on over at Toad's place.
What about Faith's husband?
I don't know. I couldn't really tell. But he could be in trouble. And we should go there anyway to search her apartment. Toad might have to wait.
Whenever you're ready. Did Toad say who was there? Was it the woodsman?
I don't know. It's possible. Whoever it was, it didn't seem like Toad was happy to see him.
Well, maybe Prince Lawrence can wait.
Yeah, he didn't see him. He could use some help, too.
Well, where to first?
Bigby! Shit! Listen, right? There's a bloke upstairs going through all the woodsman's things.
You think he did it? What's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
Toad sounds like he needs help right now. We can check in on Prince Lawrence after.
Okay. I'm not looking forward to breaking the news to him anyway.
And we ended up going out the window, and I landed on Toad's car.
You guys made a real mess.
Yeah. Looks worse in a day.
Is somebody up there?
Hey! Wait here. Shit.
I'm sorry.
That's enough, all right? Just shut it.
I don't even remember half of this shit. Doesn't make this much of a mess. What kind of asshole swings a lamp at a guy?
Is that his son?
Toads? I think.
Be nice in there, okay?
Bigby! And Miss White! Surely you didn't come all this way just for my bother. Sorry, Bigby. It's embarrassing to have to admit, but I thought there was someone else in Woody's place. There wasn't, though. Not when I checked. Nothing but a leaky drainpipe. Imagination must have got the best of me. So, you know, false alarm. Sorry for dragging Miss White into this.
There was someone, but they took off when we got here.
Is that right? I guess your dad's ears have a year or two left. Haven't gone totally to the dogs, eh?
Are you all right?
He's fine, Miss White. Just stung his little toe. Better swimmer than walker, just like his dad.
Wanna...
So, I guess you'll be taking off now. No need to hang around here anymore. I mean, I'm sorry you came all the way here for nothing. But it was nothing, really.
I'll leave when I'm ready, Toad. I just want to check things out first. The longer you talk, the longer this takes. So just stand over there and shut
up. All right, all right. I just don't want to waste your time, is all. Have a seat. Have a cup of tea. Whatever you like.
Phew. Grown-ups. Am I right? Hey, you know what? Flycatcher said you had a pretty awesome insect collection. I'd really love to see it. Is it in your room?
It has a weevil.
Cool.
Just mind the upholstery while you're looking for nothing.
Yeah, sure thing. How'd this happen?
Fucking hell. Damn thing must have fell off a table.
Uh-huh. The lamp just fell off the table.
Well, the boy was faffing about, playing sods and swordfish. Who knows with the lad?
Bleeding?
Why? Is that...
It's blood. Still fresh.
Oh, well, I cut me hand. Ran around like a tit trying to pick out a wrap. Must have got some on the furnishments. Lamp in pieces, blood on the wall. It's awful, I know.
Sounds painful.
Oi! Don't you go mother-ending now. The wound didn't sit very long, you know. Perks of being a fable, I suppose. And a frog. What is it now? If it's blood, you know what happened.
No,
I...
there's marks here on the windowsill. And what's that about?
No real reason. Just last night, when I'd come out, I was in a downright dizzy, mate, as you would be. And I plumb forgot the keys to this place. And I had to climb in through the bloody window.
Really?
Scared Junior off to death.
Here.
The poker? What of it?
There's more blood on the tip. Did this happen before or after you came in the window?
After. I was poking the coals and it slipped a bit. Sliced up in my foot like a seashell. Looked like a shit ugly thing. If you're gonna say something, out with it.
You cut yourself, but didn't put the poker away after?
Oh, I'm sorry, me housekeeping's not up to your standards. Oh my god, will you not make a big faff out of this? There's nothing to solve here, Sheriff. I'm telling you everything that happened. Why don't you believe me? I mean, things happen, you know. No crime and a little accident.
This apartment's a goddamn mess, Toad. Looks like after a struggle or a fight. And I don't know why you cover for it. But I know you're lying about something.
But I'm not...
And you're just gonna make it worse for yourself the longer you keep up the act.
I'm not bullshitting you. Honest.
We'll see.
That more blood?
No, just a clean space in the dust. Did you move something?
Maybe one of Junior's toys or something? I mean, who knows? Okay, Sheriff, now what?
What kind of toy was it?
Lord, if I know. Bigby, he has so many worthless baubles.
Though most people think they are.
Uh-huh. How's it going?
Toad's hiding something, but I don't know what yet. Did the kid say anything?
No, nothing really. He was really upset, though, earlier. He won't say why. Something's going on.
Stay with the kid until I figure out what. And why's the lock busted?
Eh?
The lock. It looks like somebody kicked in the door.
A spot of dust and a broken lock. What are you getting at, mate? Oh, for Christ's sakes, a fucking lock's been busted for weeks, mate. Right, it's just like everything else in this bloody building. Bloody hell, Bigby. What sinister bit have you uncovered this time? I left the tap water running? Didn't stop the recycling? What's the point of all this, mate? Really?
Why haven't you fixed this? Anyone on the street could just walk right in.
There's better priorities than busted doorknobs. And who's gonna come in and take anything? There's nothing to take. Bigby, come on. I'm begging for mercy over here, old boy. I was looking forward to a nice afternoon. Just me and me son, and you've taken up enough of a day with all this... the sniffing around at me private belongings. I'm sorry I called, really I am. But will you please, just bugger off?
Not yet.
Not yet. No one fought anyone, Bigby. There wasn't any scrap. So when? When are you gonna leave? I mean, I feel like I'm on trial here. In my own bloody home. It's not seemly.
When? When you start telling me the truth, Toad.
But I've told you the truth, mate. Do Jesus Christ, what more do you want?
Tell me what happened. Right now.
I keep telling you, this is just a misunderstanding. A series of accidental mishaps. This is all getting a bit stressful, all right?
I have my limit for bullshit, Toad. And I think we reached it 10 minutes ago. Now, you're gonna tell me what's going on here, or I'm gonna start...
Dad!
Bigby, is this really necessary?
Oh.
What is it? Is it hurt?
He's hiding something. Either something he knows or something he's kept, but I won't play any more games with him.
Dad?
Oh my God.
Take off your hat.
Bigby, you didn't...
He didn't. It was that butcher, a Tweedle, Dharmadee. You gotta strip them down to their johnnies before you can tell which is which. They come bulging in, screaming about something the woodsman had. Or thought he had, I don't know. He tore up the place, beat me up when I said I didn't have it. I tried to go out the window, but he pulled me back in.
What did you tell him?
If you're worried about your own skin, forget it. I didn't tell him nothing about you or your shit. I would have told you. I wanted to, really, I did. But he said if word of this ever got back to him, if he ever thought you knew, or Miss White, he'd come back and kill my boy. I even tried to give the bastard a coat. He wouldn't take it.
Whose coat?
The girl.
Dad borrows things from people who live here. Sometimes.
Borrows?
I don't steal nothing. Turn around here would astonish you, mate. I merely repossess what's been left behind.
Well, we'll be taking the coat now. If she has next of kin, family, anyone.
All right. Fetch him the fur. Fine bit of dress it is. No, I wouldn't wear it outside.
Wait. It's an envelope.
Fucking hell, of course there is. For my luck, it's a map to some bloody doubloons.
It's addressed to Prince Lawrence. Do you want to try and give it to him, or...?
I'm sorry, Faith.
What could she have been sorry for?
I don't know. But maybe Lawrence does.
Well, it's been quite a surprising day for all of us, hasn't it? I'd see you out, but I'm afraid of dripping any more blood in the place.
It was very nice talking to you, TJ.
Thanks. See ya.
I'll be honest, Bigby, I don't really know how to feel about what happened in there.
We got what we came for. Some information. He'll be all right.
So, the prince is now?
Lawrence's, yeah. It's our best lead.
Our only lead, really.
When you put it that way.
I don't want to stay here any longer than we have to, so let's just pick an approach and stick to it, okay? Just humor me.
When the magic mirror showed me this apartment, I think I saw a knife inside, covered in what looked like blood.
I wasn't expecting that.
Yeah.
Well, like I said, let's not overcomplicate things. You can question him while I look around for it.
And if he objects?
We're here on official Fabletown business. And we can be persuasive if necessary. Or you can. Don't just peep into someone's house. Check if he's home.
Can you hear me?
Oh my God.
Go get Dr. Swinehart. I'll stay with
you. No! No. Let me go. She.
What is it that you're telling us? Bigby, water. Kitchen. Did you find it yet? If you have something to ask him, you should do it now.
Is this about Faith?
Faith.
Do you still have that letter?
Yes.
It's only two words, but he died without seeing them. I'm sorry. We need to figure out what happened here and find whoever did this.
Through the chair. Yeah. The angle works if he shot himself.
When do you think that was taken?
Before all this. Strange. Hard edge to this pool, like something was here and got moved. Stuck to the bed a little. My dearest Faith, I never meant to hurt you, and I cannot endure knowing that I have. This
This was for the best. I'll see you again. Love, your devoted Lawrence.
Hopefully they're together now.
About all we can hope for at this point. It's sharp. There's blood on the blade.
Is that the same knife you saw in the mirror?
Yeah. I don't know why it's over here.
I just don't understand. Why would someone want to kill him? Fingerprints?
They'll be on the grip and the trigger. Matches the caliber of the gun on the floor. Dusty. No one's read these in a while. Stay here!
No!
Hey! Stop!
Leave me alone!
Ease up, Bigby. We're on the same side here.
You son of a bitch. Make me run after you. Why did you run?
What?
Why did you run?
Fuck, man. Because you chased after me. The fuck was I supposed to do?
A man's dead.
I know how it looks, but I had nothing to do with that.
And who did?
Look, I was just asking him about the girl. That's all. When I mentioned her being dead, he freaked out. I figured someone had told him. How was I supposed to know?
Shit.
Fucker shot himself right in front of me. I couldn't stop him, man. You're looking for the woodsman, right? I know where he is. My guy says he's holed up at the trip trap. We can go over there right now, the both of us. My employer's looking to ask him a few questions, too. The fuck?
Come on.
Dumb.
Dumb? Yeah, it is. Look, it'd be much easier for you
no,
to...
No, I'm D. He's dumb.
You almost looked peaceful.
Yep.
Except you're lying in a dirty alley. With an open wound on the back of your head.
Yep. Where'd they go?
Well, after the one guy hit you, and the other one finished kicking you...
That explains the ribs.
Then they jumped into a car and drove off. Come on, get up. Guess we're out of options.
D mentioned the trip trap.
Then that's where we'll go. I'll call a cab. Every time I think I'm getting a handle on what's going on, things just get more complicated. It feels like we're always a step behind.
The woodsman is the only lead we've got, and he was one of the last people to see Faith alive. Getting some answers out of him will start to clear things up.
I hope you're right. Bigby, be honest with me. Who do you think did this? I know it's still early, but I just feel a step behind.
The woodsman. He had the motive. He had the means.
You sound so sure that he's guilty.
At this point, I'm smashing a glass on that guy's head and dragging him out of there. We'll figure out the rest later.
This side of you scares me sometimes.
You're doing a really...
Sorry.
I was just going to say, you're doing a good job. I thought you should know that.
Thanks. I appreciate that. So, Nothing. I just... Seeing all this today, there are fables that are struggling worse than I'd imagined. We pay so much attention to the residents of the Woodlands. You forget there's a whole community out there to serve. To have to turn to... prostitution. I wish there was more we could do. This isn't how I thought it would be. But Crane runs things his own way.
You're doing your best. It's all anyone...
Obviously, you don't know what I do all day. Right now, I'm the gatekeeper, making sure none of these disenfranchised folks are, as he puts it, wasting his time.
You'll fix it.
I don't know. It's just a broken system. The fables who walk in through the back door like Bluebeard, we have all the time in the world for them. You try and come in through the front door, through the proper channels, asking for anything, needing help. Well, I turn you away. Now things are worse off than they've ever been.
Well, that's not true.
Right. We've had it worse. Much. Maybe this isn't for me. I thought public service was pure.
You'll figure it out. You're better than I am with this political stuff.
Well, that's not saying much.
I trust you to make the right decision.
I hope you're right. Maybe you should handle this one.
Yeah, maybe I should.
Bigby. Just be careful, please.
Always.
What do you want, Sheriff?
I'm looking for the woodsman.
Well, he's not here. So I guess you can go now.
Look, I'm not even gonna ask where he is now, okay? I just want to know the last time he was here. That's all.
Who?
I'm being nice. So try again.
He hasn't been here for a few weeks. No, maybe. I don't know. But yeah, he hasn't been here in a while, if he's been here at all, which... I don't know.
I'd just like some help, and I'll be out of here.
Well, I'd be willing to help you out of here. Would that help?
Come on. Have you seen the woodsman around?
I don't know who that is.
Big guy, beard, flannel, kind of a shitbag. Hard to miss. You sure you don't know him? Come on. Tell me what you know.
I know you're an asshole, and you're not wanted here. How's that?
It's fine. I walked into that one.
Let me solve the mystery for you. They're pickled eggs.
Oh, I know what they are. I'm just trying to figure out why anyone would eat this. You got any change for this thing?
Nope.
Stools in this place.
You got a problem, friend?
I don't like you, and now you're sitting right next to me.
You could ask me to move.
You're gonna order something? Are you? Here to bother my customers. You know what I mean.
Give me a Midas gold.
You want a lime?
No.
Well, I don't got any anyway.
Think that's funny?
Yep. Think it's fucking hilarious.
It was all right. This is serious, Holly. Harboring a fugitive is gonna get you in as much trouble as he's in. You could lose everything. out of paper towels and... Number one or number two? For your sake, I hope it was two. Otherwise, you're probably shitting your pants right now.
You and me been going at it for hundreds of years. I'm through fighting.
Not sure I believe you. You're in luck. I decided to switch seats. Last fella put his hand on me, ended up with an axe in his head. Last fella I put my hand on, ended up in the ground.
It's okay, Grim.
It's funny. Just a minute ago, no one seemed to know who you were.
Yeah, well, everyone knows you. Big bad wolf. Now I'm the bad guy and you're a sheriff. What kind of fucking world is that, huh?
Come on, Woody. You know why I'm here.
You wanna know what happened?
Amongst other things, sure.
It's funny. The shit you're willing to do for money. I'd walk past her place for weeks. She didn't look like it. She had money. I was sure of it. And she wouldn't put up any kind of fight. I was gonna rob her. And the night I finally get up the nerve to do it, there you are, fucking things up for me. You were just in the wrong place at the wrong time.
What are you talking about exactly?
Red Riding Hood, her grandmother. I was there to rob him. But when I showed up, you were already there, lying in the bed. I only saved her because I thought she might give me a reward. But she didn't give me shit. Except a bunch of people thinking I'm something I ain't. I played along as I could. Only thing I managed to get from it was a free drink every now and again. Not a good that did.
Did you kill Faith?
What? Faith? Who's that?
The girl you were beaten on this morning.
No. I was here. I swear.
It doesn't look good when a girl you were just smacking around shows up dead hours later.
She's dead? Bigby, listen, I'm a piece of shit, okay? I know that. I hit that girl. I did. I shouldn't have, but I didn't kill her. You believe me, right? They're gonna string me up, Bigby. Like you said, it looks fucking bad. It looks really bad, but I didn't do it.
He was here. That's the fucking truth, Sheriff.
You see? Bigby, please. You can't. They'll throw me down the witching well. That's what they'll do. And I didn't do it. You know that. Hey! Stop! This isn't what I want!
Oh, shut the fuck up, Woody! Shit ain't just about you. It's about this fucking lapdog. Only comes sniffing around this part of town when the rich fucks in the woodlands need a shakedown. Ain't that right, Bigby? Lapdog? Really? Holly's sister goes missing. No one gives two shits about her. Paperwork. Waiting rooms, and that bitch Snow White looking right past me, then ushering me out the fucking door. That all you got?
Seemed to be enough.
Don't be so sure. Oh, good.
Should have walked out of here when you had the chance.
Come on, you're scaring the lady.
Don't worry about me.
He's had enough.
I'm the lapdog, huh? Here, fetch.
You fucking monster! Double.
This never happened. I'm good. Don't even think about it.
Is this the type of treatment I can expect if I let you take me in?
Hey, he started it.
All right, I got $100 for the first bloke that can tell me something about a girl named...
That's not necessary.
Shit.
He's the one you want, not me.
Your brother won't be saving you this time. Come on. You're under arrest.
I told you I didn't do it.
And you got nothing to worry about. Anything stupid, and I'll throw you down the witching well myself.
We had something very special.
Where's your brother?
Fuck you! Give me one good reason I should tell you anything.
Serial killer.
Oh my.
A serial killer? Oh God, it's one of us.
Wait, the woodsman's still walking the streets.
Got to put a lid on this.
If you can't manage it, I'll find someone who can.
I found out where she's been staying.
I know she's here. You must have seen her. What are the two of you hiding?
Thanks for not saying anything.
Doesn't matter. Maybe you just want to punish someone. We can arrange that.
What did you do?
Friend on friend. At the end of the end.
Jesus Christ, Bigby.
Is that you?